Hello, fuckers. Welcome back to the Dolce Vita Lifestyle Channel. This is Flirting with Danger. I am your host, the dangerous one, Jason Danger here, Jason Equi. And this is the Danger Lounge coming to you live. If you like this video, and by all means you will smash that like button, whoop, and you'll make a comment down below. Send me a text if you know me, and share it with your friends. And if you don't like it, then you will share it with your enemies. This is to the gentlemen out there. Now, again, I know that there's a variety of people out there that are capable of getting divorced. But since women initiate most of the divorces in this country, we're going to make this out to the men out there. Because some of them wanted it and some of them didn't. But regardless of how you got here, men, I want to be the first to say congratulations. You made it. I'm happy for you. I'm really happy for you, actually. To the ladies out there, I know you get divorced as well, and I'm happy for you as well. I tell you that when it happens. Now, certainly I'm not happy if you're not happy about it. And I think that any time that the sanctimonious union of two people that have committed to each other has dissolved, I find that to be unfortunate. However, now that you're here, we might as well have a good time now, shall we? Your freedom, the shackles are off. Hopefully you're not paying any child support or something, but I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing with you. But do you feel a little bit better? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Woo! Okay. Congratulations. You made it. You made it. Maybe you don't feel that great right now. That might be why you're watching the video. Maybe you feel a little bit down. Right? You're like, oh, you know, fuck, I don't know. That's what I was used to. You know, I'm not the kind of guy that gets out there. I'm an introvert. You know, oh my God, it was really painful. That sucks. I'm picking up the pieces of my life. A lot of people have been where you are, and it sucks. Just breaking up out of a normal relationship is heavy sometimes. And a marriage has got to be obviously more difficult. But that being said, it's time to get back on the horse there, buddy. I'm going to teach you how. I'm going to tell you how, because this is an epic opportunity for you and for you not to make the same mistake again. I'm just kidding. That's up to you. But for whatever reason that you're here, I think it's time for you to smile, pick up your balls off the shelf, and let's get rocking. Let me tell you what your next steps are, okay? This is advice for you now that I've been through many breakups. I've even been through some other stuff, divorces and things. So I know kind of where you're coming from. Okay, I get it. And there's a tried and true methodology to A, getting over it if you haven't gotten over it yet, or B, maybe just getting back out there and, you know, what are the next steps? Okay, and we're going to talk about a lot of things here to help you because that's what I'm here for. So while we do, Flirting with Danger, about social dynamics and about helping you out there, using my experience, my expertise to help you through this trying time. Now, and to make it not that big of a deal, remember we have perspective. I've done videos about perspective and gaining perspective and putting things in a proper perspective. And while this may seem like a huge ordeal now and an insurmountable object or just a major inconvenience anyway, really doesn't have to be, right? It should be actually fairly fun. Okay, we're gonna reframe this for you. So, I'll be honest with you. When I break up with people, it's tough. But once you go through quite a few breakups, I've dated a lot. For example, while breaking up is hard to do, I don't find it to be a huge deal, because I look at it probably differently than the average person. Everything in life has a life cycle to it. Businesses, there's a life cycle. It's very predictable. Relationships are very predictable. There are phases to relationships, okay? And if you're not going to marry the person, you're not going to stay with them in a romantic setting anyway. You might have sex with them occasionally, but you're probably not going to stay with them as a couple forever. Same with marriage. Most marriages aren't going to last, especially nowadays, and women initiate 70 to 80% of those divorces. Okay, so there's all kinds of weird dynamics that are being twisted and changed in society that makes staying married very, very difficult. It's almost as if they don't really want us to be married, you know? Anyway, I am geared to be more of a bachelor, but I've been in many long-term relationships and many short-term ones. And I will tell you that when you get out of them, it sucks, but it sucks for different reasons. So first, let's discuss if you're having a hard time with it. How do we get you out of that feeling? Okay, so we can get you back. You can't get back on the horse if the horse's leg is broken. Okay, so we need to figure out first, why are you feeling that way? Now, if you've married somebody or even been in a relationship with them for a long time, you developed the comfort drug, right? Oxytocin, the cuddle drug as well. Oxytocin settles in. I mean, we can make a really long video of this, so I'm going to try not to make it that long. If you want me to go into detail, you let me know. But what tends to happen when we get relationships, specific, it's committed, you know, first of all, that your testosterone, let's say it was here. These are facts. You can look this up. Your testosterone levels are here when you're single. When you get in a committed relationship or a marriage, it drops to here. Okay. Well, I don't know if you can see at the scale. Okay. Drops to here. Here's the good news. Well, let's first talk about this. Depression is tied to lower testosterone levels for guys, okay? And probably for women too, I can look at that. But that's not a coincidence. Now, the other hormones that tend to take place in long-term relationships or tend to take over are more like oxytocin, which is a cuddle drug. And oxytocin, well, it gives you a feeling of comfort, the pair bonding that you feel. And whereas, you know, if you're staying with that person for past, let's say 3 months, for example, that's why I always say 3 month rules are important, and you're not sleeping with anybody else, or you're not taking breaks in between, you're going to experience that feeling of needing to be with that person, right? You're going to feel like you want to cuddle them. You want to, you know, and that's sort of like sedate sort of feeling. We've all experienced that. It usually comes about 3 to 4 months in a relationship, and it goes back and forth in these sort of things, up and down with the levels of oxytocin. Women have a higher level of it. Men tend to have it after they've been sleeping with a girl for a while. Not as much as women, but it's still there. But your testosterone drops at the same time. Okay, I'm not saying one is called, I'm not saying it's causal. I'm just saying that tends to happen. Been in a relationship for a while, your testosterone drops. You're not out there hunting anymore. Okay. Now, we're not going to get into that, whether that's good or bad or any of that stuff. You're out of it now, so it doesn't fuck out of that. But I will tell you this. After you break up with that woman, the woman you've been dating or married to, the testosterone levels soar past where they were initially when you were single. So I don't know if you ever experienced this. I have. And that's like one of the best parts about breaking up. You can feel it. It's like goes through you. It's like fucking lightning. Like you can walk through a wall, like, right? And it's like you can conquer all. That is one of the greatest highs. You can go out and you're like, bring me all your, you go into town, you're like, bring me all your women. And it feels wonderful. Bring me your whiskey. Bring me your women. I want to watch some football. I want to go dancing to the wee hours of the night, which I want to do anyway. And I want to have some damn good times. Make some connections, you know? Break some breakthroughs. Get creative. All these things come surging back. You have the ultimate perspective. Look, hormones don't hurt when it comes to that kind of stuff. So there's got to be a lesson there somewhere. I'll let you derive from that what you will. But there's got to be a lesson there, no? Okay. So very important. So how do we gain this? How do we get over it, first of all? What is the cure of love? And is there such a thing? Well, it just happens there is. And as far as I know, I'm the one who invented this list. Not that I know everything about it. I certainly don't know everything there is about love. But let's first talk, gentlemen, and let's get really fucking blunt about love. Now, talk about it. People throw it out there all the time. It's all over their houses. Love, love, love is this, love is that, love is kind, blah, 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 right? No one ever stops to talk about what it actually is or research it or read books about it or the science behind it or what happens. Well, fortunately for you, I've done a lot of that research. You'll find that most people don't know shit about it, but they're awfully willing to commit really quickly to it. And if you did that, let that be a lesson to you. But regardless, I'm not here to judge you. There are different types of love. What you've been involved with is romantic love. Now, I argue that respect is more important than romantic love because that's fleeting and that's based off of hormones. Oxytocin, dopamine, serotonin, valpressin. Is it valpressin? Vaspressin, I think is what it's actually called. And obviously testosterone, estrogen to some extent, right? But what tends to happen is, where was I? I was going somewhere really good with this. ADD. It's easy as 1, 2, 3. But what is, I think there are different types of love, right? Romantic love. There's love, parental love for the parents. I think that one of the true loves is parental love or you know, grandparents to grandkids or anything like that. That's familial love. To me, you know, I know that so for certain family members, my mom, my grandparents, when they were alive, my dad, you know, probably my sister, you know, certainly certain family members. It doesn't matter how badly I screw up. They may not be happy with me, but they're still going to love me, right? That doesn't change with hormones, okay? And if you don't think hormones matter, by the way, there's a reason why when you're an infant, you can do no wrong, especially to the mother, if it's a healthy mother, because they have different hormones going. And those hormones are that because a baby's going to fuck up a lot between 0 and 2 years old, right? And it's going to shit itself and it's going to vomit all over the mother and it's going to cry constantly. But no matter what, that mother's going to be there because it's got to take care. So biology made it mandatory that mother pay really close attention to that baby. Why? Because the baby is absolutely helpless without the mother. Okay, so that's why that makes sense. So the mom, it doesn't matter how annoying that baby is, that mother is right there, attentive as always. Now, year two, something happens. Those hormones come down a little bit. Now the mother starts to notice all these annoying little things their two-year-old little brat is doing, right? Coloring the walls is no longer cool, right? Running around screaming all the time. So look at the terrible twos. Why is it the terrible twos? Are they really any different than the terrible one and a halves? Probably not, but now the hormones have changed. So it does matter, okay? It does matter. Now, we talk about parental love and all that. That is basically it's unconditional, okay? Pretty much, okay? If it's a healthy mother and family and all that, okay? But now, romantic love, as you know, gentlemen, is not unconditional. It doesn't matter what you do. You can be the greatest husband in the world. You could show the most understanding, spent the most money, bought the best gifts. It makes no difference because women are generally guided by emotion. And in today's society, it's cool to divorce for whatever reason. I don't know. I'm not here to judge one way or the other. But I'm here to say that it happens and it's becoming more and more common. And loyalty is not when it comes to that sort of thing. And so behooves you to understand that relationships, like most things, have a time limit. Get used to it. That is normal. Ride the fucking wave. Get used to it. That is normal. If you've been in a relationship for 30 years, 40 years, whatever, like our grandparents were, you are the exception, and congratulations, because that's not easy. And good for you. But for most of us, that's not going to be the case. Get used to it. Relax. I'm here to teach you how to get over this shit real quick. Okay. There is a cure for love. Okay. Romantic love is fleeting. What is it? Okay. What is it that we're talking about? I'll tell you what, this is not popular to hear this, guys, but if you're just recently divorced or broken up, you're going to identify with this and you might be more apt to believe me now than you might have been before. Okay. This is like me coming to you and telling you that there's no Santa Claus. You're not going to be happy with me right now, but sit on it, think about it, let it marinate, come back to me, and I'll accept your apology and your thanks, your appreciation. And you can buy me a beer. Okay. So this is how it works. Romantic love is a couple of different things. One, when you fall in love, it's simply loss of perspective. Now, if you were seeing 10 different women at the time, were you going to be in love with any of them? Probably not, because it was perspective. You also didn't have any sort of oxytocin going on, which is, gives you that feeling of losing control and being cuddled and almost that feeling of desperateness. You've all felt that. You can be the most undesperate or non-desperate person. Is that a thing? Indesperate, I don't know, whatever it is. You can be someone who's really not desperate. But if you're only sleeping with that girl for a few months, a couple months really, and you're with her all the time, you've cut off those other women, you've lost perspective, but you've also incited the hormones, specifically that cuddle drug known as oxytocin, and that will get you to pair bond with her. That's why we always say, parents always say they know their 16-year-old 16-year-old daughter or son is seeing the wrong person at 16. Watch out, because if you've seen them for too long, even if you know that's not the right person for you. How many times have you dated somebody and you're like, this is not the right person for me? But for whatever reason, you're going through a rough patch in your life. You're down, you're maybe a little depressed or over a variety of different things, possibly. It could be a number of different things for whatever reason. And you find yourself with this chick that you're like, I don't even like this girl. Why am I? But you're just like kind of depressed, and there's not a lot of other stuff going on. So you end up dating that girl for a while or sleeping with her. And then suddenly, like, you feel attached to her. And you're like, oh, well, I guess, and you end up staying with her. Heaven forbid you marry her. Okay. But that's what happens, because you either don't have other options, or I always say this. I tell guys this. Think about every time you got in a relationship. Like, if you were dating 10 girls at a time, right? You were having a blast, weren't you? Okay. You're probably having a really good time. It's a really good time in your life. You had perspective. It was going great. Maybe you didn't like that, though. That wasn't your thing, though, maybe. Okay. But whether it was or wasn't doesn't matter. When you think about all the times in your life where you got in a relationship, but let's say 6 months or more, I can almost guarantee you that if you think about what was going on in your life at the time, it was a struggle time for you. All right. You were having some challenges in your life, and maybe you're a little depressed, maybe you were down, whatever the case may be. I can almost guarantee you it coincided with that. Now, if that's the case, you might want to ask yourself, why? Right? Because I don't think guys generally do that unless they have lack of options or they're feeling depressed at some level. Okay? Think about it. I'm not 100% right. There's exceptions, but really think about it in your own life. That being said, now what? Lost perspective. We already said that. What's next? Love is also hormones. Right? This is not that Disney has taught us, conditioned us to believe that this love, this romantic love, is magic. Right? The same myth that says if you treat a girl so great, they're going to love you. And you know that's not true. Okay? Nice guys finish last when it comes to women, or second last. Okay? So we know that's not true. That's a myth. So what is it? It's hormones. Love is also hormones. Biology doesn't give a shit about your convenience. It doesn't give a shit about social conditioning. This is a human thing we've constructed. It doesn't give a shit. Its goal is to have. Its goal is to have you spread your seed around to keep your genetics going, survival, your lineage, your legacy. The best strategy, the best mating strategy to keep your DNA going, which is to spread around other women's DNA. That's what your little penis was designed to do. Okay. And That's not convenient for a lot of people here. A lot of people hate that, you know, whatever. But it is biologically, how do you argue that? Okay. And I told you I was going to be blunt in this video, and I am. And the other thing is, you know, for women, what are they designed to do? They hit carry one baby for 9 months. So they're going to have a completely different mating strategy. Okay. Understandably so. But as a guy, you must understand and embrace your mating strategy. I'm not saying you got to go out there and be promiscuous. I'm not saying that. But embrace being a man. You don't have to be ashamed of it. In fact, don't be ashamed of it. Embrace it. Watch 300. Okay? It's good for you. Can't you feel it? Like when you broke up with your girl, like, assuming you're not depressed now, as soon as you get back on home, you're going to feel that surge of testosterone, like everything's possible again. You know why? Because it fucking is. Your balls are off the shelf. You're not going to IKEA during the weekends anymore. You're not in your fucking basement, your little man cave, watching fucking TV and watching other people's adventures while you have displaced your own. Rise up, gentlemen. It's your time now. It's your time. Grab your dick and balls. Let's fucking rock. So, what is the cure to love? Okay, so anyway, we discussed what that romantic love actually is. Loss of perspective, hormonal changes, isolation a lot of times. It's a desperateness to some degree. Okay. And I know that sounds terrible. I don't mean that love is desperate. Okay. I just mean that when you're desperate, it's easier to fall in love. Does that make sense? Let's discuss the cure of love. What are the steps? There is an actual methodology that I've come up with. It's what I do whenever I break up. I can usually get over a relationship in about 2 to 3 weeks, typically. When I say get over, I mean, will I still care about this person? Yes. Will I still sometimes have hurt feelings when I think about the situation? Oh, absolutely. But at least I'll be able to function. And I won't like get really upset about the relationship. Okay. So number one, it can't be isolated. Cannot be. It's very bad. Cannot be isolated. Do I have this written down somewhere? That'd be easier. I know this is in my head. I have it written down somewhere because I have this as part of my book that I'm writing. But stay tuned. But let's talk about it. First, you have to acknowledge what love is, which we just did. What is it actually? And you have to face that fact, what it actually is. It's not some magical thing that happens to you. Love is in yourself. It's not in that other person. A lot of times love is, this is the third one. Love is insecurity. Think about it. The most insecure people are the ones that want to find love the most. Think about it. I know that doesn't sound right, but it's true. It's true. So the less insecure you are, the less you're going to go out seeking it. Now when you do find a partner like that, then you're probably going to be, it's probably going to be a better fit for you because you're not putting out some sort of desperate vibe and you're also not feeling desperate, right? Because you don't feel insecure, right? And you have perspective. So one thing is you have to identify what the love is. We did that. Also, now you have, this is the big one. Well, the other thing is you got to get rid of every connection there. You can't talk to her anymore. Now, if you're married to her and you have kids and all that, of course you're going to talk to her, but you can't talk to her in those ways anymore. Okay? All that romantic stuff is gone. You talk to her like a business partner. Okay? And you cut off any possibility of getting back with her if you don't intend on getting back with her. All right? And there's pictures in the house of her, shut those down. That's over with. Now, you must refocus on your purpose. This is a big one. What is your purpose? You may not even thought about it for a while. Never, maybe you've never thought about it. What is your fucking purpose? What are you here to do? What are you here to contribute? What's your vision? All right. I always say, what is that you're, if your life is a canvas, a blank slate, it's up to you to paint something magical. Craft it. Craft your life. Add your layers. What layers do you want to add? What skills do you want to do? What languages do you want to learn? What places do you want to travel? What kind of people do you want to meet? What do you want to create? Right? What is your purpose? That should excite you. You're back in the game. You have opportunities that you have less hole in your back now. You don't got anybody bitching in your ear. Not that she was doing that, but she probably was. So go fucking do it. Go fucking do it. What's stopping you? Now you take that grant. If you never thought of it this way, you take that granite slate, right? That big marble piece slab, and now you have that vision. Now you every day you just craft it. It doesn't matter if anyone else knows what you're fucking doing. You have this beautiful piece of art that you're about to contribute to the world. All right. And you know that is the, and how do you craft this? Through experiences. La Dolce Vita. And if you want to be part of the Dolce Vita network, then you contact me and you can join and you'll be with like-minded people that are trying to choose their own adventure as well. You're crafting your own adventure. I'm here to provide, help you provide interesting, awesome experiences and people to connect with to achieve your said desires and goals. But that vision, that purpose, right? Focus on that. You have life goals. You had them before. Focus on that. Because remember, you can't put all your eggs into or all your effort into people sometimes, because people are variable. They're not reliable. Even people close to you sometimes. But you can do that to goals, and you will get a return on investment if you're focused on your vision, your purpose, and your goals, right? Whether that be sports, a business, a hobby, a passion, whatever that might be, but your visions. Okay. Now that you've done that, you continue to do that. That's going to put things in perspective, but now you need more perspective. You need to start connecting with people and realize there's more out there than your tiny little fishbowl. Now you need to go on some road trips. It can be with a buddy. It can be with several buddies. It can be by yourself. Sometimes the best ones are by yourself because you got no one holding your back and there's no compromises. Make this about you. Get a little selfish, buddy. You've not been selfish for a while, is my guess. So get out there, connect. And that's going to give you the ultimate perspective, because now you're really meeting other people, connecting, and realize there's all kinds of people out there with different perspectives, different ways of looking at things, different life philosophies besides yours. Travel, learn new cultures, eat new things, right? Meet a lot of different women, which is the next one. Meet new women as soon as possible and connect. If you don't know how to do that, watch some of my other videos. Again, I'm writing some books. Contact me. I will be your personal dating coach if you'd like. But get out there and do that. Give you a marketing strategy, right? And don't fall, and by all means, don't just fall into another relationship. Okay. Keep them moving around. What do you do, right? You gotta be dating multiple people. I'm not saying you gotta sleep with all of them, but date multiple people, because you don't want to fall in the trap of what I was telling you, where these hormones start kicking in, not just the wanting to have sex hormones, those are good ones. I'm talking about like the cuddle drug, and then suddenly you're dating somebody that's not even good for you, and you start losing perspective again, and then you start like getting that it's not, and then you're right back in that vicious cycle again. Don't be desperate. If you want another mate, that's fine, but don't be desperate. Make sure it's from a good state of mind. All right. And the best way to get a state of mind is have perspective. And the best way to have perspective is to have multiple people that you're going out with and doing multiple things. Okay. You know, get a taste for a multitude of different cultures, if you will. Okay. It's good for you. It will give you perspective. It will give you clarity. And that's what you need. And then it's just start to reframe things. That's the last step, I think. Start to reframe things. So every time you rethink of that relationship, it gives you pain. Look at it as a positive. Look, every relationship teaches you something. It wasn't a disaster, even if it was a disaster, right? It teaches you something. You're not going to make the same mistake again, if nothing else. But you learn so much about yourself through dealing with other people. That's why I say it's good to date a lot of people, because you're going to learn a lot about yourself. You're going to learn about as much about yourself as you're going to learn about them. So it's really good that you go out again and date other people, but also reframe it. So if you have a negative associations with that previous relationship that you came out of, the marriage or the long-term association, every time you think about it with something positive, positive spin, whether it was something you learned about it or some cool experience that you had, but just reframe it every single time. It's going to become less and less painful every time you think about it, okay? And then just start dating other people. I know it probably sounds very daunting to you right now, but it doesn't need to be. It's fun. I know it probably seems weird to you because it's been so long, but you've been isolated. What does that tell you? Right? You're not meant to be isolated as a human being, but that's what relationships tend to do sometimes. So anyway, I can go into much greater detail on this. If you want me to talk about more of this stuff, let me know. I don't really publish these videos or mark any of my videos yet, so there's not like that many people watching necessarily, but I am open to doing social dynamics are kind of my thing. I love social dynamics, so you know, if you need me to individually coach you, I can do that. I am writing a book about these sort of things, and I've been working on that for quite some time now, so I think that's going to be hopefully sooner rather than later. I'll be putting that out. But in the meantime, if you need more help or you want me to make more videos going into greater detail about this stuff, let me know. But in the meantime, you get out there and you have some damn fun. That's the main thing. and enjoy the bachelor lifestyle. Enjoy it. Have your own setup. Do your own thing. And remember, what do you do now? The answer is, whatever the fuck you want. Because you're a free, independent man. And that's a beautiful thing. Don't you forget that. I know there's a lot of guys coming out of relationships right now that say, but I don't want to be free. I don't want to be independent. I want her. Come on, grab your balls. Let's go. This is going to be fun. This is good. I know you don't want to hear it right now. So I've been there. I've been there. It sucks sometimes. But you know I'm right. And you're not going to feel that way forever. Trust me. And then when you don't feel like that, and I'm telling you what that usually coincides with, you find this really hot or amazing girl that's interested or attracted to you, right? And you're attracted back. And then suddenly you don't really, well, okay, I've got some perspective here. You're not even thinking about the other girl, right? Unless you're feeling insecure about somebody because your confidence is low. Maybe she broke up with you, right? Remember, it is normal to not be, for relationships not to work out. Whether you broke up with her or she broke up with you or it was mutual, it's normal for relationships not to work out. It doesn't have to be personal. It can just be cyclical when it comes to relationships. That it was that time in the relationship where it was time to break up. That's normal. A lot of people just hang on because that's what they're supposed to do, or they have kids, they just hang on. But they're just basically living lives. I wouldn't say quite desperation, although a lot of people are, but they're just living lives of contentment. I have found in those sort of relationships, my observations and my experiences, and again, I'm not saying I know everything, but the highest you ever get is contentment in those scenarios. Think about it. The highest you ever get is contentment. Because the best part of it is when you first meet them and you go through that honeymoon period and right? So experience that with new women. But once you get in that long-term relationship, contentment doesn't seem to be a lot of joy from my experience. I've seen a few times there might have been some exceptions, but generally speaking, contentment is as good as it gets. Most of the time, it doesn't even get as good as contentment. It's, all right, well, all right. Can you get out there? And like Chris Rock said, fuck your hopes and dreams. Fuck your ambitions. Now, get out there and make that bitch happy. I'm just kidding. But that's a Chris Rock bit. If you haven't seen that, it's fucking hilarious. YouTube that. In the meantime, that's not your concern anymore. Get out there and make you happy. And if you have any trouble doing that, again, join La Dolce Vita. It's going to be a good time. Join the La Dolce Vita Network. We talk about life philosophies. We provide interesting experiences and really cool vetted people to meet and to help you choose your own adventure. Any way you want to do it. We're going to create your lifestyle. You're going to create your own adventure, and we're going to help provide you people and experiences in order to do so. So if you can't go to Vegas with me, we'll bring fucking Vegas to you. All right. Until next time, gentlemen, for whoever needed to hear this, good luck to you. If you need anything, you can reach out to me. We've all been there. You're not alone in this experience. And the fact is that you don't want to be alone. Come out there and connect. There's all kinds of really cool people to meet that are going through similar things, or they want to meet you because they think you're cool. It might even be a really, really hot chick. So till next time, don't get down, stay up, and live dangerously.